Hello again. A partly cloudy day across Sydney. The wind chill from southerly winds making temperatures feel around 3 degrees cooler. Across our suburbs, Penrith reached a top of 24 right on average for the month of April, but that was after an overnight low of 10 degrees, 3 below average. Blacktown, Parramatta and Liverpool all reaching tops of 23 degrees, 20 for Cronulla and 22 the top for Terry Hills. It was mostly dry and sunny across the state with clear skies bringing a cold morning across inland areas. Bathurst and Mudgee fell to 3 degrees overnight, an overnight low of 4 degrees for Dubbo. The mid-north coast temperatures ranging between 25 and 27 degrees. Tomorrow, showers and storms could affect the northern tropics. Tropical cyclone Paul has formed over the northeast Coral Sea, the eighth in the Australian region so far this season. It is expected to remain slow moving over the northeast Coral Sea during the remainder of Thursday and on Friday before weakening. An onshore flow should drive coastal showers over the eastern seaboard, high pressure keeping elsewhere dry. Taking a look at our capitals, Brisbane 27 and a possible shower, Canberra cloudy with a top of 21 degrees, 18 the top temperature for Melbourne. Tomorrow, parts of the mid-north coast could see a shower or two, mostly dry elsewhere. Overnight temperatures will be a bit warmer than the past few days, a low of 6 for Bathurst and 8 for Mudgee. Back home in Sydney tomorrow, a partly cloudy morning with light winds becoming moderate in the middle of the day, a top of 24 degrees. Mostly sunny in our western suburbs, 25 for Penrith, Blacktown and Liverpool, 24 the top for Parramatta, 22 for Terry Hills. Looking ahead to the weekend, mostly sunny days with overnight temperatures continuing to stay a degree or two above the monthly average. 24 the top temperature on Saturday, 25 on Sunday. By Wednesday next week, we could see a few drops of rain with the chance increasing come Wednesday and Thursday. Our western suburbs, temperatures remaining in the mid-20s, 26 the top for both Saturday and Sunday. A warm start to the week with 28 degrees on Monday. We could see a light sprinkle of rain heading our way from Tuesday, Georgie.
Hello again. Although Melbourne's comedy festival is in full swing, the grey skies have been no laughing matter. The city failed to reach 18 degrees again today, peaking at 17.7. Eastern suburbs have only done slightly better with maximums of 19 at Rosebud, Frankston, Ringwood and Yarra Glen. It's been another uneventful day statewide. The only temperature of note has been Brother Glen's chilly overnight low of 3 degrees, but it rebounded to reach 22 this afternoon. Wodonga has been the warmest location in the state with a top of 23, which is spot on its April average. In WA, Olga has weakened to a tropical low, but stepping in to take its place, tropical cyclone Paul has formed in the Coral Sea, but it's considered unlikely to make any significant impact as it's currently tracking to remain offshore. Tomorrow, the high that's south of WA will finally start to move eastwards later in the day, and it'll edge much closer to us on Saturday, signalling a shift to brighter and slightly warmer weather. Perth is enjoying the warm weather right now, 29 tomorrow, 21 in Adelaide and Canberra, 19 in Hobart, which is 2 degrees warmer than the April average, Sydney 24 and a top of 27 for Brisbane. Back home, it'll be a little cooler overnight with much of the state heading down to single figures, and there'll be some patchy fog over Gippsland. Then Sale and Mallacoota should reach 20 degrees, but the high teens elsewhere through the south with a few isolated showers about. Northern districts will enjoy blue skies, although not a lot warmer, heading for the low 20s. Melbourne's northern and outer eastern suburbs are expected to dip to single figures overnight, down to 7 at Coldstream and Fernie Creek. And there'll be areas of fog around during the morning. Showers will be confined to southeastern suburbs, clearing in the afternoon, and most suburbs should reach 19 degrees. Cloudy skies for Geelong, but there's only the slight chance of a shower, a low of 10, a top of 19. The city is more likely to get a sprinkle, and after dipping to 12, it's expected to reach 18. And there should be a few breaks of sunshine in the afternoon. Then things will brighten up for the weekend. We'll see a lot more blue sky on Saturday and a little warmer, 19 degrees. Partly cloudy and 20 on Sunday, 21 on Monday, 19 on Tuesday with light morning showers, 18 on Wednesday and Thursday. And that's what the city's heading for tomorrow, 18 degrees. Mostly cloudy with showers through the southeastern suburbs early in the day. And if you're playing weather bingo at home, 18 is a good number to have on your card.
Good tip, Lavinia. Thank you very much.
Oh, we certainly have, Andrew. Over the past few days, it's all been due to those southwesterly winds or that cooler, drier air moving in. Take a look what we captured here from Mount Gravatt Lookout just over an hour ago. A magic sunset and plenty of people with the camera out capturing this one, wrapping up with a nice golden glow on the horizon. And a little bit of cloud though moving back in from tomorrow afternoon and into the weekend, and that's when we could see a shower or two, but it'll be mainly coastal, not a lot of rain in the forecast. Let's have a look at temperatures across southeast Queensland. And fresh this morning, as we mentioned earlier, 5 degrees the minimum in Oakey, Toowoomba Airport, 7 in Kingaroy, 10 for Ipswich this morning. The maximum recorded in Ipswich and Brisbane were 28. The Golden Sunshine Coast hit 26 today. The weather map, onshore winds and coastal showers for New South Wales and into southeast Queensland, southern Victoria and western Tassie. Showers and storms in WA from the remnants of ex-tropical cyclone Olga, while in the northeast Coral Sea it's tropical cyclone Paul, a category 2 storm but should weaken late tomorrow. For the capitals, partly cloudy and cool in Adelaide, Hobart and Canberra. Showers on the way for Melbourne, sunny in Perth and Sydney, chance of a shower in Darwin. Queensland for Friday, partly cloudy and low 30s, Cairns and Townsville. Slight chance of a brief shower around Mackay and Gladstone. An afternoon shower around Bundy, Maryborough, Gympie. Sunny and warm inland with low 30s in the north and central west. Southeast Queensland waking up to a mostly sunny day. The best chance of a shower will be along the coastal fringe in south to southeasterly winds. Overnight temperatures are 12 to 18 degrees. Daytime temperatures in the mid to high 20s. Redcliffe 26, Gatton 27 degrees. Moreton Bay, south-southeasterlies, 15 to 20 knots. The seas, 1 metre on the bay. Brisbane, mostly sunny around the city. We are looking at light to moderate east to southeasterly winds, a high of 27 degrees. Your 7-day outlook, well, possible shower Saturday and Sunday, partly cloudy Monday. A shower or two returning Tuesday, 27 degrees each day. Ipswich, sunny and warm Saturday. Chance of a shower Sunday, partly cloudy and warm for Monday, Tuesday. For the Gold Coast, a couple of showers over the weekend with a possible shower Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. 26 for Saturday, Sunday. And on the Sunshine Coast, a shower or two, 26 Saturday and Sunday, partly cloudy on Monday. Not a lot of rainfall in it, guys, just a couple of coastal showers. There we go.
Hello again. I tell you what, we are in just a real typical textbook autumn pattern at the moment where the weather is just so stable. Nothing's really changing for the next week or so, and it's very, well, basically easy conditions. We could do with a little bit more rain, but we'll keep our eye on that one. 20.7 degrees was our top in the city. Right now it's already cooled off to 16 degrees. Around the suburbs, we did have a couple of light splashes through the hills, but we're talking like half a millimetre to a millimetre around Crayfers and Belair. Not much in it on the plains. We had 21 degrees at Mawson Lakes, but it was cold up at Mount Lofty under all of that cloud cover. We had just 16 degrees there today. Through the north of the state, basically a dry day. 20 degrees at Whyalla. Clare also reached 20 degrees and it was 19 degrees at Port Lincoln. And then through the south of the state, we did have a couple of light splashes around Mount Gambier with 16 degrees there. Narracourt made 19 and Victor Harbour also came in around 19 degrees. So taking a look at the charts, and we have that high pressure system. It's just kind of hanging out, just continuing to direct those southwesterlies or the southerlies over South Australia. And it's just really keeping things quite mild with the odd shower here and there. Interstate, Sydney looking mostly sunny tomorrow, 24 degrees the top. Canberra going for 21. Melbourne, we could see a shower or two there with 18 degrees the top. So through the north of our state tomorrow, looking pretty dry and sunny across the top. Broken Hill going for 22, Roxby Downs 25, Port Lincoln a little bit cooler with 20 degrees in store. A little bit like today, and we're essentially looking mostly dry. But then we could see the odd shower turning up, perhaps along those southern coastlines. Mount Gambier more so just a cloudy day and a top of 18 degrees. Narracourt expecting 19. On local waters, pretty light winds, turning southerly in the afternoon and seas to around a metre. Temperature-wise, pretty similar to today. 20 degrees at Golden Grove, 20 degrees at Glenelg, 21 for Marion. We're also looking at 21 degrees in the city with dry conditions remaining. And then after that, this 7-day forecast, it's really quite, you know, consistent, 21 and 22 degrees right the way through until about this time next week, Kate and Brenton.